You feel like there's someone missing on your team, or you're unsure of who you need to hire, or maybe what position needs to change? In today's video, I was talking to an associate of mine. We were building out his team, and we're specifically talking about who he has on his team and who's missing. So I told him a story about when I was an electrician running million-dollar jobs for the union, and we had this one job, I think it was about $3.5 million behind due to mess-ups, chaos, confusion, all kinds of stuff happened. But needless to say, how do we take it from being $3.5 million in the hole to over $1 million in profit over the course of the second half of the job? Well, the answer was simple. We reorganized the crew and created a specific team that worked together and supported one another. Would you like to know the secret yourself and how you can apply it to your business? Take a look at this video and see who do you have, who are you missing, and what change do you need to make, no matter what the department or the specification or specialty that your team offers.
I'll tell you a story about when I was running a job as an electrician. We were doing a ghost station. We had, what was it, like 15 people, and I was running the crew. For those of you that didn't know, I am a licensed electrician as well as everything else. And so when I first got on the job, it was an absolute mess, chaos. Like, things were just a disaster. We won't go into it. So what I did is, first thing we did is start off with the team and make sure that we have the right people in the right seats doing the right jobs based on their skill sets. And so we had four different styles of teams. The first team were the pipers. These were the ones who laid the conduit, who could lay the groundwork, get the walls ready, hang all the support material, and basically the grunt work. They had to be really skilled in order to do the pipe work, because this was rigid, meaning it was thick pipe, anywhere from 3/4 of an inch to 2-3 inches, multiple runs, and it had to be bent and screwed together. So it's not the simple stuff you see in most electrical. This was more in depth. So they had to be skilled, but their job was the grunt work and lay the groundwork. So where does that lie in your team? Who is it that you need? Are your grunt workers, or your pipers, as I call them, that need to lay the initial foundation and framework so that the rest of the team can come in behind them and do what they do to the best of their ability? That's what my pipers did. And so they were always the first team into a room or on a floor. The second team were my wire pullers. Now, these individuals had, it wasn't as hard a work. It was easier work, but it was more detail oriented. They were the ones that had to pull 50 or 60 wires through a cable and make sure that it was color coded, identified, tagged, and went to the right directions, that when it hit an octagon box or when it hit a junction point, that it separated into the correct areas. So these people had to be able to read prints, understand the big picture quickly, and keep everything very, very organized, because one mistake could cost us thousands of dollars. All right, makes sense. So again, on your team, who is it that needs to be able to go through after the grunt work is done, after the main foundation is done, and do the attention to detail pieces, connect all the dots? In the case of electrician, they had to make joints, etc. Right. So it was very important that it was done right. Or else, when you turn on the breaker, it would have potentially cause a fire or a short circuit, etc., etc. The third were my fixers. Now, your fixers, the difference between a fixer versus the piper and the wire pullers is the pipers and wire pullers had a very consistent job. They were planned weeks and months in advance. They knew exactly where they were going, what they needed to do, and I had the blueprints ready and the schematics drawn up and the plans created for the job in advance. And I'm assuming on your crew, Winston, you have that as well, right? The projects and the tasks that you're doing, you have people in advance that you know what they're going to be doing a month from now, 6 months from now, etc. Make sense? Yeah, perfect. So for the fixers, however, that's a completely different story. So there was one crew specifically to fix whatever came up. Now, I always had a rule that nothing changed within 24 hours, because if you're changing a team's process in 24 hours or less, now you're losing time, because now they have to go pack up their tools, move locations, put everything away, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It's just not worth it in less than 24 hours. So it was always a one-day notice of what they were doing the next day. But the fixers, they have to have a specific skill set. They have to be quick. Very, very quick. They have to be extremely skilled in multiple areas. And they also have to like the unknown, which was big. The mindset had to be that they actually enjoyed doing something new every single day, that they actually enjoyed having the challenges or the obstacles or the headaches or different things that came up. Because some people love when you look at it and go, oh my God, this is going to be a real pain in the, right? Other people love that sort of thing. So the fixers have a different mentality than the pipers or the wire pullers. And so you have that team is the team that goes in when there's a mistake. You don't pull from the other two teams. That is the team specifically there to solve the problems. And then the fourth crew were your apprentices. These were the individuals that kept the other three teams going smoothly, efficiently, and effectively. They made sure that all the material was arranged, that everything was organized, that stuff were delivered on time, ahead of schedule, that when you know the piping crews go into a certain room or a certain floor, that the apprentices the day before are getting all the material there and are corresponding with them to make sure they have everything they need. So that is your, I mean, in all honesty, without the apprentices, everything else falls apart, because even though they're the lowest person on the totem pole, they were the ones that if you ran the apprentices correctly and with proper communication, kept the other three teams running smoothly and effectively. Because the last thing you want is people stopping what they're doing in the middle to go search for material, go find things. Is this making sense so far?
It does. Yeah, thank you.
Perfect. So I've always, even though that was electrical, that was contracting, I've always applied that to every team I've built and when I'm working on other companies. Because if you have your pipers, your foundation framework, you have your wire pullers, which is a detail-driven, dot the I's, cross the T's people. You have your fixers, the ones who at last minute repairs or obstacles or fires come up, you have the people to jump in it. And then you have your apprentices, that's your support. Those are the ones who provide, make sure that you have what you need, where you need it, when you need it. And if something comes up, they're the ones that go running for you to get it for you and to support you in that process. And often in exchange for that support, they want knowledge. And that's the trade-off between the two. When you have someone who's that the apprentice, they're supporting you in exchange for knowledge and experience. You've got to not take advantage of them and treat them like the lowest one in the totem pole. You trade off the fact that they're supporting you with sharing your experience, giving them chances, opportunities to try new things, etc. So those are the four teams I think every company must have based on an electrician as an example. Any questions or comments?
No, that was awesome. Thank you. Appreciate it.
So there you have it. Now you know the four types of crews you need in every department. So let me ask you this. Who do you have? Here's an exercise for you. Take a piece of paper. On the paper, across the top, put your departments. Across the left-hand side, put the four categories. You have your pipers, your wire pullers, your fixers, and your apprentices. And put the names of each individual for each department. Where are they? Who do you have? Do you have the right people in the right seats to do everything that needs to be done? Or is there missing pieces? Or you're a bit like most business professionals, and you have one person sitting in multiple seats. And that can be fine, but there's risk. The risk? Often, switching our mindset from doing the grunt work and laying the foundation to being a detail-oriented individual, to being the fixer who has to be able to adapt and adjust on the fly, different personalities altogether. And so if you have one person jumping between three different seats and having to go and run their own material and get all the foundation and lay all the legwork, unless they're extremely organized and disciplined with their time, you likely have chaos and inefficiencies in your production. So take a look at it and do this as self-assessment yourself. Which departments? Which people, who is doing what's role, make the adjustment so that it suits your business. And if you have any questions, send us a comment, let us know. Or better yet, you want a true audit of your team? You want to find out who you have in the seats and if they're sitting in the right seat? At no cost, I'll give you a complimentary ticket to do a free audit of your team at no risk, no pressure. Just click the link down below and see for yourself, who do you have in on the bus? Are they sitting in the right seats? And are you ready to scale your business? Because if not, you can't scale your business if your sales system sucks. So go ahead, click the link down below, and I'll see you on the next video. Talk to you soon.